Dear fellow colleagues, today we are going to talk about nucleus removal in soft cataract. Before I go further, I will be dividing this talk in three topics. Number one, the concept of central safe zone. Number two, how in normal cataract surgery, nucleus is brought in the central safe zone for aspiration. Number three, problems in soft cataract and soft nucleus and how to overcome them. Let's start with the concept of central safe zone. All aspirations, may be nucleus, epinucleus or cortex, must be performed in the center of the anterior chamber, what I call as the central safe zone. Here, the cornea is convex forward and posterior capsule is convex backwards, thus having a maximum space for performing the Phaco procedure and preventing inadvertent damage to posterior capsule, iris or cornea in case of a surge. Coming to the next concept, and that is how in normal cataract surgery, nucleus is brought in the central safe zone for aspiration. Step number 1. Nudge the nucleus with foot pedal at position 2. Step 2. Bury the Phaco tip in the nucleus by giving the Phaco energy with foot pedal position at position 3. Step 3. Hold the nucleus with the vacuum seal by bringing the foot pedal back to position 2. In this position, a vacuum seal is created and nucleus is held and lollipopped onto the Phaco tip. Step 4. With the foot pedal position at position 2, chop the nucleus. Step 5. Pull the chopped nucleus into the central safe zone with the pedal position at position 2. Step 6. Emulsify and aspirate in the central safe zone by switching the foot pedal position between position 2 and 3 using the energy as and when required. In this way, nuclear fragments are prolapsed from the capsular fornix and brought into the central safe zone. Coming to the next concept of problems with soft cataract and how to overcome them. The two problems with the soft cataract are, number 1, no good vacuum seal or hold on the nucleus. Number 2, sticky epinucleus that does not allow you to pull the nucleus in the central safe zone. In soft cataract, as soon as you nudge the nucleus and try to create a vacuum seal, being soft, it gets sucked into it. And if you lower the vacuum too much, the hold is poor, so you are not able to get a good grip on the nucleus. Also, in soft cataract, nucleus and epinucleus are very sticky. The epinucleus adheres to the nuclear surface very strongly, so much so that you are unable to pull the nucleus into central safe zone. What happens as a result is that you tend to suck out the nucleus into the peripheral unsafe zone, where it is in close proximity to the posterior capsule, and you may land up in posterior capsular rupture. Now, let's talk about how we can overcome this problem. Here, in this video, we are removing the anterior part of the epinuclear plate within the rexus margin as in our routine cases. Now, we suck the part of the anterior epinuclear plate between the anterior surface of the nucleus and the capsule. To do this, place the Phaco tip close to the rexus margin and apply the suction. There is no need to use the Phaco energy for this. Usually, a vacuum of 300 plus minus 100 is enough. Epinuclear plate can be easily removed up to 200 to 220 degrees without rotation of nucleus. Once we have achieved that, then we can remove the rest of the epinucleus by rotating the nucleus and remove the whole of the 360 degrees of epinuclear plate. While removing the epinuclear plate, no Phaco energy is used and it is only the suction power of the Phaco tip. After epinuclear plate removal, make a trench in the nucleus and divide it into two, like a normal stop and chop technique. During the whole procedure, our tip will remain in the central safe zone only. See how easily the nucleus collapses into the central safe zone. And now, with a little Phaco energy and mainly suction, it can be emulsified and sucked into the Phaco tip. Using the chopper, the other half is taken out, divided further, emulsified and sucked with ease. Now, we remove the epinuclear plate. With the suction force, just flip it. And with suction and intermittent Phaco burst, it is aspirated. And thus, the surgery is complete in the central safe zone without ever venturing into the periphery unsafe zone. Now watch the second video. Again, we are going to remove the epinuclear plate between the anterior capsule and the anterior surface of the nucleus. Once this 360 degree of epinuclear plate has been removed, we will prolapse this nucleus in toto without dividing it into the central safe zone, and watch how easily it prolapses into the central safe zone. Therefore, no phacoemulsification is done in the peripheral unsafe zone. Now, we divide the nucleus into two, and with the vacuum settings of 450 mm of mercury and flow rate of 36, we emulsify and aspirate this nucleus. Thank you. You can watch the unedited phacoemulsification video for soft cataract by clicking on the link in the description below. Thank you very much for watching, and please like and subscribe our channel.